Welcome everyone to Beyond the Notes, a series in which you and I are going to search for the reasons why we are so connected to certain pieces of music. Because let's face it, good music, regardless of style, skips the brain, connects to our heart and souls directly. There is a language, there is a story that we can feel in music, but why is that? And I will be honest with you up front, that will remain a mystery forever. But what we can do is reveal certain aspects, some small details, sometimes not even much, that makes you see some elements in the piece that you didn't see before, or can establish that emotional connection with a piece of music that you didn't have before. That's what this series is about. So, enough for this introduction, let's get right into the content. But first, a word from our sponsor. This video is sponsored by you. You are an amazing community. A few weeks ago, we launched a Kickstarter for the CD release of the WTC, and you funded that project in only 1 week. Thank you. There is still time. There's a link in the description box. Check it out because you can have your name on that CD recording. How cool is that? And if you see this video in the future, no need to panic. That recording will still be available in our web shop. There is a link in the description box for that. Check it out. Today we're going to have a closer look on Bach's Prelude in C minor. Bach wrote this piece around 1722 in his famous bundle Well-Tempered Clavier. That's a bundle of 24 preludes and fugues, one prelude and fugue for each key. So C major, C minor, C sharp major, C sharp minor, and so on. C minor obviously is one of those preludes. C minor is not a very joyful key, as we all understand. The mood is very somber, it's very depressing, it's revolting maybe, but there is a plot twist at the end. Let's listen a few seconds first. So when we strip all the 16th notes, so the busy notes from this piece, and we get a skeleton of a few notes only, a bass note and a top note, which is kind of the melody. It's the main note, and it's not hidden anywhere. It's just covered by the abundance of 16th notes. So the first beat and the third beat, they have a very simple, very calm melody, and you will see that the character of the piece just remains intact, even is enhanced maybe a little bit. Let's listen again, but now with this in mind. There is something very special that you might have noticed or not. There is a counter melody or a counter note. It's not really a melody in the sense of the 19th century where you have a melodic line that could be sung by a singer. Well, you can sing this, but it's a counter note, a counter melody, and that's also not hidden. Yeah, it's covered by the 16th notes maybe, and by the abundance of rhythm, but it's very prominent on the second and the fourth beat, and if you combine those, you get a very telling interval, and an interval is more than just two notes. An interval creates an atmosphere on its own. Like for instance, the first interval we hear is an octave. That's going from high to low. Very symbolic in Baroque literature. And you may have your own story here in a sense of it's God talking to us humans, or it's something else that is like a kind of happy situation and a sad situation. Doesn't matter. It's this octave that goes down, and the intervals that go down stands for sadness. And that's the power of music. Regardless of what you make of it, we feel that like that. Listen. Go to A flat. It's very threatening already, like there is something going on. Then B against C. Prominent C in the bass. Okay, with these two notes in mind, let's listen just again and see if there is an extra layer added. We come to the most mysterious presto in the music history. I'm making a little bit of a joke, but this presto is something that we as a musical society don't know really what to do with that. For me, the solution is that it is an anticipation of the adagio and allegro, so more or less the same tempo, because the harmonies actually get more dense. It's also what you hear. So instead of like having very broad harmonies per bar, actually only almost, it's a very solemn feeling. With all these 16 notes, it gives this counterbalance. This is great. Suddenly Bach makes the harmonic consequence, the more harmonic sequence, I should say, more dense. And listen to what happened in the presto. It's the culmination, it's the climax of that feeling of like, I do not accept this situation. I want to go somewhere else. So after this, he doesn't do that. He expects an answer, and there is the moment in this short piece where the character, the main character, the hero of the story, is actually sitting down and really reflecting all these turmoil, all these 16th notes, all this motoric feeling, the thing that pushes you forward, this rhythmical drive, stops. It's nothing. And I hold the E, it's not written there, but I like it. In clavichord you can do that. What does Bach do after this F? That's a pretty harsh interval, a diminished fifth. And then we get like, as if this adagio didn't happen. And chromatic. And then. So he continues, but like not over the entire instrument. Very dark, very deep, very, very somber. Like down, 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 but to where? To this bottom C, foundation of this piece, and maybe foundation of life. Everything is symbolism, and music certainly. But where do we go? Where do we go? Up, 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 up we want. To where? Yeah, E natural, but going to F minor, so it's not yet positive. But then, there is a C hanging in the air with a little tail. And that note is E natural. It's a very tricky line to play because you end in a kind of motorical drive, but you want to make a kind of ritardando, because otherwise you hit your face with the wall. There's too much information there. I did a little trick in the recording, which I'm going to play for you. But listen to how this piece ends. I told you at the beginning, there is a crux to the story. There is a positive end, and this is the positive end. We connect to the sea. That's where we want to be, from this to there. Earth, heaven, certainly in Bach's time. That may be true for you as well. And we are happy. We go a little bit down. Of course, we cannot be there at the sea. But here we can. It's not. It's an E natural. It's unbelievable ending. I play it for you. One of the most beautiful moments in the entire book is this one. I struggled a lot with how to play this, and I'm very, very happy with that. It's not literally written like that. It's an interpretation. Whatever. Let me know in the comments what your feeling, what your story is with this piece, what your connection is, why you like this piece. Did you get something out of this story that I shared with you? Leave it in the comments. Also, leave me in the comments if you have pieces that you would like me to talk about in this series of Beyond the Notes. Happy to read that. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.